AP Physics is commonly regarded as the most difficult course offered at COSA. Even some of the easiest problems can end up looking like this. Fortunately for you, in this introductory video, we will preview every topic in the course so you can get a 5 on the AP exam and finally gain your parents' approval.
Man, I'm so excited for this gravitation lab, bro. It's gonna be such a good time.
Yeah, me too, bro.
It's gonna be awesome.
We're just up here on the math and science roof getting ready to do the gravity.
Dude, Ryan!
Whoa!
Bro, what the?
Yeah, we're just gonna learn about gravity and stuff. So, yeah. This...
Oh, no way!
Understanding the concepts of displacement, velocity, and acceleration, we can use kinematics to predict how objects will move, based on mathematical relationships and equations. In free fall, objects accelerate downwards at about 9.8 meters per second squared. And knowing this allows us to calculate launch speeds, the heights of various structures, and much more.
But what causes things to accelerate? That leads us to our next unit.
Newton's first law says that a body in motion stays in motion unless acted upon by another force. That is called inertia, and I'm about to prove it.
Newton's first law. An object will not change its motion unless acted on by an external, unbalanced force. There are many different types of forces, including gravity, normal force, lift, tension, and friction.
That's what me and my ex-wife have.
The sum of total external forces is equal to mass times acceleration, which means that the acceleration is determined by the forces and the mass.
It's simple enough when things are straight, but what happens when they start going in circles?
I woke up in a new Bugatti. I woke up in a new Bugatti. I woke up in a new Bugatti.
Uniform circular motion refers to an object in a constant speed moving in a circular path. As you can see, we are accelerating inward towards a circle due to a force known as friction. Very interesting physics we're seeing play out before our eyes.
This next unit is all about the conservation of momentum, including things like collisions. Momentum refers to the quantity of motion that an object has and is determined by mass and velocity. Impulse is the change in momentum which occurs in collisions. Collisions can range from inelastic to elastic, but either way, momentum is conserved.
As I tumble down this hill, my gravitational potential energy is converted into linear and rotational kinetic energy. Let's take a look.
Energy can come in many different forms, including potential, kinetic, thermal, and work. Energy is never lost. It has to go somewhere, and in this case, it is mostly converted to kinetic.
When I slam on the brakes, my kinetic energy is converted into heat energy.
Power refers to the ability to create change, and in physics, means the rate at which something is able to produce energy or work. In this clip, we can see Spencer running up the hill and converting his kinetic energy into gravitational potential energy, but at an extremely fast rate, which means his power is very high.
Here we have a very, very simple angular momentum problem. And as you can see, very, very rudimentary steps here. You use the cookbook to get to the final answer right here.
Torque is where things can get fun, but luckily if you follow the cookbook, you will be able to solve any problem provided. The same ideas of energy, momentum, and force apply with rotating things. As Ryan applies torque to this spinning thing, its angular velocity increases. As Spencer descends the hill, his gravitational potential energy is converted into rotational kinetic energy as the friction force from the ground applies torque, making him spin faster.
Rotational momentum is determined by rotational inertia and angular velocity, which is why when I put my arms and legs in, my velocity increases because momentum is always conserved. Here we have an example of a physical pendulum. Let's see what happens when I push it.
This unit explores various types of oscillations, primarily in springs and pendulums. In this case, the restoring force that pulls an object back to equilibrium is proportional to its displacement from the equilibrium position. This is called simple harmonic motion, and it follows the pattern of a sine wave. Springs and pendulums have a certain frequency based on a few select factors, but actually, every single object in the universe has a certain natural frequency. And this includes objects out of this world. Studied by scientists going back to Kepler, Newton, and more, one of the weakest forces known to man, and yet somehow, the most powerful.
Filming?
Yeah.
Welcome to Zion National Park. Today we're going on a little hike, taking a little detour to Bryce Canyon.
In reality, AP Physics is not just a class about physics, but how the world works. This class will transform the way you comprehend the universe and give you a deeper understanding of the physical world we call home. If math is the language, then physics is the story. AP Physics allows you to actually apply calculus in the real world, discovering the fundamental workings of reality. Now that you know the course, you're ready to take the AP exam.
What the?
put all of your money into slots. All of the gambling, your house, your car. It's not luck. It's all skill, all intelligence.
The biggest bet is the next bet, all right? That's what you gotta know. That's what you gotta know in gambling. Take out that loan, put it on slots. Let's win big.
Spencer, where are we right now?
Oh, that's hard.
Am I gonna be okay standing on this?
Yeah, you're fine.
Explaining gravitation, and Joseph's gonna edit a planet coming down to the Earth. Yeah.
The dogs are out.
The dogs are out.